All right, what I would like to do is show you how to use an algebraic method of balancing this chemical equation instead of sort of guesswork, which is the way a lot of people do it. I know that I have to have a coefficient number in front of each of these terms in order to get the equation to balance. What I'm going to do is just assume these numbers are, we'll call this one A, call this one B, call this one C, and call this one D, and we'll figure out what those numbers are. On this side of the equation, I have 8 times A carbons. 8 times A carbons. I have to have the same amount on the other side of the equation. On this side, I have C of them. So that means 8 times A is equal to C. So I'll take my C and I'll replace it with 8 times A. Okay, next, how many hydrogens on this side? I have 18 times A of them on this side. So I have 18A hydrogens on that side, and on this side I have 2 times D. 2 times D. That tells me that 9A equals D. So over here, instead of a D, I will put 9A. Alright, next we have oxygen. On this side of the equation I have 2 times B. 2 times B oxygens. On this side of the equation, I have 2 times 8A, that's 16A, plus 1 times 9A, plus 9A, and that is 25A. That means B is equal to 25 over 2 times A. So up here where I see a B, I'm going to replace that by 25 over 2 times A. Now, all of the terms only have an A in them as their variable remaining. Choose A to be anything you want. We will choose A to be equal to 2, and the reason is so that it gets rid of this fraction. So, I choose A to be equal to 2, that means there's a 2 there. 25 halves times 2 is 25. So there's a 25 there. 8 times 2 is 16, so there's a 16 there. And 9 times 2 is 18, so there's an 18 there. And there you have it, balanced equation. No guesswork, very precise, and I think much easier than just trying to figure it out by guessing.